Hey guys, happy Friday. I thought I'd do a vlog this weekend. Hopefully I can go through with it. I also wanted to give you guys a little update on why I have been absent from YouTube. I've been in a funk, a little bit of a funk. Plus I've been a little bit ill. I'm having a very awful GERD flare up. This doesn't usually happen to me unless I take a round medication that's strong, like 800 milligram ibuprofen twice a day for two rounds of 10 days for foot surgery. And I didn't realize this until it happened to me a couple years ago when I had a torn rotator cuff. And I was taking it for about a month, and I had my first really bad flare-up, and had an endoscopy and everything. Turned out I had silent reflux, or GERD, and it took a while to heal. So right now, can you see it? I don't know if you can see that. My very boring steel-cut oatmeal is ready to pop in my hot water. Yes, this is the diet. Very bland, very low fat. I'm getting used to it. So, last week and last weekend I had pain, burning, like I was having a heart attack. Pain in my shoulders and my arms, and a headache. That has gone away for the most part, unless I get really, really stressed, which is happening a lot also these days. So right now I just have pain here. When I breathe in, I feel it burn in here, in the back of my tongue, in the back of my throat. Gotta watch that so it doesn't boil over. And it's just very miserable. It's an ache and it's a throbbing pain. Also, there was a headache. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Stay down, oatmeal. Okay, so this is what I have to drink. I had to give up coffee because that's very acidic. So imagine the headache caffeine withdrawals I went through last weekend. It was not fun. But this is what I drink instead of coffee. It's an herbal blend. It tastes like a mild coffee with a little creamer in it. When you just mix it with hot water, you can also mix it with cold water and it will dissolve. So it's little packets. I didn't get the big bag size because I didn't want to be doing this for long, but as soon as that pain goes away, I think I might start drinking coffee again because my mood has been so low and I'm crabby, guys. So I don't like that. I hate that feeling. I hate being like that. It's causing a lot of tension at home. And I'm just feeling down and sick and down. So that's why I haven't been around much, but I've been watching your guys' videos and just hanging out up in my bedroom in bed, falling asleep early because I think it's the caffeine. It cannot sustain my activity for a full day, even though I'm barely doing any. But yeah. Caffeine is a wonderful thing. When you're without it, you really notice how much it, well, at least for me, how much it propels my day. But let me finish up this breakfast. I have to quickly eat. I have to get out the door and get to work because I'm running a little bit late. All right. There it is. Porridge. And I'm putting our very ripe banana, a little bit of raw and unfiltered organic honey, and also, oopsie, also because I like it sweet and I don't want to use too much honey, this organic stevia extract from Trader Joe's. So, and then, because this is also non-acidic, I will put this in there because I like it swimming in some creamy stuff. No more whipped cream, guys. Yep, I had to give that up. And so this is it. Sometimes I'll put berries, but I read that blueberries are acidic, so now I can't use blueberries, and I don't like strawberries as much, so I'm just going to do banana today. And this is what my doctor prescribed. This is a prescription proton pump inhibitor, stronger than something like omeprazole, which you can get over the counter, but this was not cheap, even with my prescription plan. So yeah, I guess I have to take this for at least a couple weeks, maybe a month. I don't know. This is 60 milligram, 30 capsules. So I guess it's a month round. So we'll see how this goes. I've been taking this for about a week now, since last Friday when I went to the doctor. And those are my vitamins, minus my fish oil. And this is what my kitchen looks like these days. Yep, that, sorry for the dirty dishes, and that, and yeah, it's a lot of stuff. And there's the bag of the day. It is rainy. It was thunderstorming last night, so I figured I haven't used my nylon bag in a while. This is the perfect kind of weekend, because tomorrow it's supposed to snow. So we went from 60s, almost 70 degrees, to now a cold rain and a possible snow tomorrow, so, and overnight also. So here is the bag of the day. Sorry, I was a little shaky there with the camera or the phone. I was holding it kind of funny. But I'm off to work. I'm going to have my nice ride with my nice music. And yep, see, I have a sore throat now. And an earache. And that is the GERD. Finally done. It is 3:30 on Friday afternoon. This is my favorite time of day because I have the whole weekend ahead of me to do what? Sit in that bed and do nothing. It's about what I've been doing because of this stupid sickness, but anyway, I wanted to mention one thing. While I was at work, I noticed that at the outlets this weekend, there is an additional 20% off on the nylon collection. So how coincidental that I changed into my nylon bag today for the first time in a long time and mentioned it. So yeah, just to mention that really quickly. And also I wanted to talk about something that another YouTuber that I watch, Nessa from Nessa's Nook, mentioned in her latest video that she ordered a bag for her, I believe it was her sister or aunt or something like that, but it was a white, I think it was a Monte Catini bag, so I think that's what bag it was, but that's another higher end Dooney bag, and it came without a dust bag, so she ordered it from I Love Dooney. She called I Love Dooney and they told her, "We are no longer sending dust bags with our light colored bags because of color transfer, potential color transfer." So she then mentioned that she called Dooney.com and they confirmed that. That just doesn't seem right. If Dooney's worried about color transfer from their dark blue dust bags, then they should be providing light colored dust bags with their light bags. They shouldn't be completely eliminating a dust bag. I don't think that's right. But anyway, I guess I'm gonna drive home and see what is going on in that hotel that I live in now. Hi, it's Saturday morning and I still feel so awful. I woke up at 5 a.m. even before that. And I couldn't sleep, so I got up, I started doing some laundry. I had some Dandy Blend and some oatmeal and some bone broth. And just have been kind of I just washed all the floors, which really needed to be done. My feet are feeling better, so I can walk a little more now. The doctor told me I just have to still walk more on my heels. And so I don't know what to do the rest of the day, but I feel like getting out of here. I just don't know where to go. I don't want to spend money, but I do need to go to the grocery store. So I guess I have to go to the grocery store, but I even don't want to spend money there. I know this is becoming another addiction. Don't spend, don't spend. I've become so cheap. Yeah, I'm wearing my favorite Love sweatshirt because it's so cozy and so comfy. And I was so cold this morning. Our heat doesn't kick on until about, I don't know what time we have it set for weekends. I'm sweating because I was washing the floor. I don't know, maybe 7 or some of my hair is missing from the light. I look like I had a flat head. I do have a flat head, but that's another subject. But I don't even know where I was. Oh, it was freezing in here. I was in the basement because I was trying to be quiet and everybody was still sleeping and I was doing laundry. So I was wearing my down coat and this sweatshirt and my hood on, sitting on the recliner watching YouTube videos. I was freezing. So anyway, I got to thinking about what bags I want to sell, or I'm thinking about selling. And I have such a hard time with this because I don't want to regret my decision, but these are bags I just don't carry very often, and I find that they just don't work for me. Well, one's a hobo and it does work for me, but I have another one like it and I don't tend to reach for it. So let me just share with you guys what I'm thinking about selling. I don't know, thinking about putting them on eBay. So let's see, let me turn the camera around. So here they are, and this is the Greta, is this the mailbag? I think it is. Crossbody, I forget, but I should have all the papers anyway. But it's in the white with the black trim. I just don't really go places enough to need something that small. This one, I don't reach for it very often because when I do load it up with all my things, it's kind of heavy as a crossbody, and I'm really not a crossbody person, so I don't tend to reach for this much either because it's kind of awkward when I wear it. But it's still a great bag. This one, I really have a hard time with this one because I just love the look of this bag and how it looks on me on the crook of my arm, but it's just kind of heavy and it's large for me to carry around with me shopping and as an everyday bag, and that's really all I ever do. It's the Samba Belted Shopper in the color gray with the brown trim. I think it's the color gray. Well, it is gray, but I don't know if that's the actual color they call it. It's probably on the card. I'm sure I have that in there. And this is the Saffiano Hobo. It's the same silhouette as the Gretchen Hobo, and I tend to reach for the Gretchen more when I do, but it's a great hobo with really nice hardware, and it's in the black Saffiano leather, and I just don't tend to reach for it. I don't know. This is a beautiful bag on the crook of the arm as well. It's the Willa Satchel in the all black, black pebbled leather with black trim. It really is a nice bag, but it's one of those like this silhouette where it's just a little wide and it's a little long for me, so I don't tend to reach for it. So these are the bags that I might be putting on eBay at some point soon. The Gray Belted Shopper, I've got my listing all set up. I just have to take updated pictures because I have old pictures. When I first got it, I put it on eBay and I just didn't follow through with selling it, and I just have been, it's been sitting there on my shelf and I just don't reach for it. I took it to work with me the other day and it just was kind of heavy. So I might actually sell more than this even. I have to go through my collection and just try to part with things because I just can't afford to have things sitting. So those are the candidates. And I have a hard time with that Willa too because I really love it. But I have enough black bags and I have other black bags that work for me better. So I just can't, you know, I just can't.
So that's that.
I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm still sweating. But I don't know what I'm gonna do. I need to just get in that car and go somewhere because I'm feeling a little like, here, Noah. He's fussing. His dad's supposed to come and pick him up today and take him so that Jessica can get some homework done. She's got a lot of work due for her class, and Noah will not let her do it. But we're having a little trouble with Dad following through with what he says he's going to do. So Jessica was highly stressed yesterday, and it's just sad. But on another note, Noah was very cute yesterday. We were having such a good old time with him. Rob had him on his knee and was bouncing him up and down, horsey ride, horsey ride, and he was just, he had this look on his face like he just was loving it. So we had some fun. He's sounding a little frustrated. I feel you, Noah. I feel your pain. But okay, I need to get out and go somewhere. I hope you guys are having a great Saturday. It's kind of was flurrying outside a little bit. This morning was pretty big flakes, you know, and my son's probably excited. Hopefully he's going snowboarding today. His latest video, episode 7, I think, at Wilmot Mountain was really fun. He's got it posted on his channel called Awkward. John went to visit a college friend at his college this weekend with his girlfriend and his friend, so he's gone. And yeah, so it's just a quiet weekend. I just have some cleaning. I've been really neglecting this house since I've had my foot surgery. So maybe I should show you what my feet look like. And they're not the prettiest right now, but they're getting better. And there they are. So the gap between these toes is closing up because I've been wearing my gym shoes. This one is still really swollen on top and like pressing inward toward my toes. So I'm hoping someday, I'm sorry about the veins, guys. I have veiny feet and hands. I'm hoping someday that they'll match. And there is the scar. And there is the scar. And looking pretty good. This one is 2 weeks ahead of that one in recovery. So yeah, they don't really hurt when I walk. I just have to walk on my heels and it sucks because it's hard to do that. So there they are. They're still a little stiff. But yeah, definitely, hopefully healing nicely. Sorry if that was a little gruesome. I think I can maybe put nail polish on them now. I'm not sure. I'm going to have to ask at my next appointment. On Monday, they're going to take x-rays. And maybe I'll ask if I can put some nail polish on there and make them look at least a little nicer. But who cares? They're always in shoes anyway. I have to walk around at all times with my gym shoes on. I can't just, you know, get up and walk barefooted even around the house. So that kind of stinks because I'm not used to having my feet confined in gym shoes all the time. It's just very kind of restricting for me. So I do sometimes when I'm sitting at my desk at work, take them off and wiggle my toes and let them, you know, decompress a little bit. So okay, maybe I'll just get in the car and drive. Well, I settled on Target and I got the very closest spot to the door. I swear, every time I come here, ever since my foot surgery, I've been lucky enough to get a close spot. How does that happen? There's even an event going on at the arena right next door, and there's a ton of cars here because people tend to like to park illegally in the Target parking lot when they go to events at the arena to avoid paying the parking fee. And they don't even get in trouble. I don't get it. I don't know why the cops are not sitting here watching. Anyway, not my problem. I have to go in there. I have to get some co-leaf for Noah because he's colicky. And we used the last of it last night. So And then I don't know, just whatever I always get at Target that I don't need. You ever go to Walmart on a Saturday? Nuts! It's crazy there. I never go to Walmart because it's not near my house, but because I had to go there to return Jessica's stroller, I shopped around for some other things and I was gonna walk out with nothing. But I remembered Tracy B mentioned around the holidays that she likes these Scentsationals. Or I think some are Scentsationals and some are Better Homes and Gardens. So they have a ton of them. So I just spent some time, you know, opening them and sniffing them. And I have a couple of burners, but I don't really like the cubes that I have for them anymore. They're kind of like way too perfumey or something. I don't know. But so I just, these are like $2 a piece or $1 a piece or $3.97, I think, for the value pack, which I got one value pack, which is the Lemon and Jasmine Fresh Veranda Breeze. And it's this one. And it's got lemon and a floral, I guess. But it smelled really fresh and lemony. So I like that for spring, you know. Lip gloss and hair do not mix. So then I got this Sensational Serenity Spa. It's a limited edition. And it smelled really good. Like... heck is that stuff called? Oil? What are those oils called? I forget. Okay. CRS syndrome. Sensationals Daydream limited edition. So this one smelled really good and fresh. Then I got Zen, which also smelled really good and fresh. I need a lot of Zen these days. Then I got Honey Bourbon Frosting, which smells like you're baking a cake. And then this is another limited edition, Violet Cocktail Cream de Violet, I think. This one smelled really good. And then this one smelled really good, Warm Apple Pie. I love going to Grandma's, it says. So Noah is at Grandma's, so I'm going to burn these when I get home. Although Noah's not at Grandma's right now because he went with Daddy. So he'll be back later though. Okay, I pulled over to show you what I got at Walmart. Now I'm going to drive home. Back to crazy land. So I'm finally home and I'm folding laundry and everybody in the house but me is sleeping. Yep, Jessica's sleeping, Rob is sleeping. The one who got up at 5 a.m. or earlier than 5 a.m. is awake. But anyway, I managed to finally find those co-leaf or co-leaf drops for infants at Walgreens. Let me tell you, those are not easy to find. I'm so glad that I finally found them. I was out all over the place. Well, Target, Walmart, Walgreens. I guess that constitutes all over the place. So the rest of the day is going to be dinner and relax. What? I'm smiling at you.
I couldn't see what you were trying to do because the sun was going
on. Hello. I'm back.
Nice to see that now. Why are you filming me?
Because it's more fun when other people are in my vlogs.
Why? So it seems like you have family and friends?
Yes. So it seems like that.
Lone wolf mentality. That
I looked
have.
At TVs when I was at Walmart.
Yeah.
They're pretty cheap.
Yeah, I know. That's what I was trying to say when you argued with me that they're expensive.
But what I was thinking is,
you're gonna buy a new one here.
Maybe it would be a good idea if we replaced this one with a smart TV so that I can watch YouTube on my TV or Netflix. And then put this one upstairs. What do you think?
Yeah. This one might actually have to hang.
Yeah, I know. Or did we buy a bracket for this thing at one point? I thought we had one in the crawl space, no?
I don't think so. I don't think so. I mean, it could sit on a...
Well, the problem is...
What?
They had a couple really nice 4K TVs.
Yeah.
Cheap.
Mm-hmm.
Like for $398.
Yeah.
But they were not smart TVs. So that's the problem. It would be really nice to have a 4K smart TV.
Mm-hmm. Because eventually...
That picture was so nice.
I know, but I don't know how many... networks are broadcasting in 4K.
I know.
I know in Canada they do.
I finally got a chance to color my hair. Because the little one is not here. Yep, I'm doing a, what color am I doing? I'm doing, I think, medium ash blonde. Yep, it comes out pretty dark, and then it lightens up in about a few days to a week. So, my husband says it looks purple. But yep, I've got it on my roots. And a little more than my roots, because I'm really sloppy when I do this. But then I'll put it on the rest of my hair, the last 10 minutes or so. And then I'll be purple. Well, I'm all colored and air dried and winding down for the evening. So I think I'm going to end the vlog here on Saturday night. And I just wanted to... thank you guys for watching, and I hope you are all having a wonderful weekend. And until next time, have a great week. Bye, guys.